Have you ever wondered what the fine yellow powder in flowers is? That's pollen, and plants use it for reproduction. Most flowers need help moving the pollen from one flower to another. This is where pollinators come in. When certain insects or animals visit a flower, some of the pollen sticks to them. When they visit the next flower, it rubs off onto the stigma or the female part. Once a flower has been pollinated, it can produce seeds and fruits. Bees are one of the most efficient pollinators because they visit so many flowers while searching for food. Bees also love eating pollen because it is packed with protein. Plants know they need the help of pollinators, so they developed a way of attracting them with nectar. Nectar is a sugary water that provides a lot of energy for pollinators in search of food. Plants have different ways of advertising their nectar to specific pollinators, like the color and shape of the flowers. Some flowers are deep and narrow to accommodate the hummingbird's long tongue as it hovers in flight. Other flowers have landing pads to allow butterflies to land and drink the nectar using their straw-like tongues. But no matter how plants advertise, as a pollinator drinks that sugary goodness, their bodies also pick up pollen and carry it to the next flower they drink from. So basically, nectar attracts the pollinators, who then help move the pollen from one flower to another, allowing fruits and seeds to grow. But there's a problem. Pollinators are losing their food sources. And this isn't just a problem for the bees. We need the help of these pollinators if we want to keep producing many of the foods that we like to eat. The good news is, it's not too late for you to help feed the bees. Visit PlantSomethingBC.ca to learn how to plant a bee-friendly garden and help provide pollen and nectar for bees.